And this week's photographer is Sean Gannon.
I started in wedding photography just over 3 years ago. I've always been into photography. I've had a camera since I was 16 and it was my obsession. And I decided about 3 years ago I didn't want to work in the corporate world anymore and started doing portraits and weddings, and now I do portraits, weddings and events. When I started shooting weddings, things went fairly smooth. The very first wedding I ever did, unfortunately they didn't kiss for very long. They kissed for a nanosecond. And I just about captured it, but not properly. But now I think I pride myself on the fact of always getting the kiss. I think that kind of slightly shaky start to the very first wedding has now made me work that bit harder to get everything right on the day now. A good photographer can orchestrate situations to happen. If you just stand back and let everybody do what they want to do, you won't get those really cracking, glamorous, fantastic shots from the day. I think what I do is what I refer to as being soft posing, whereby I make sure that people are in the right position and doing the right things. Part of the day I look forward to most, I think, is the prep shots in the morning. I love doing the prep shots with the bride just as she's almost finished and nearly ready. And having that time to photograph somebody looking probably the best they'll look, and seeing the results and seeing the look in their faces when you show them the occasional picture in the back of the camera, it's just fantastic. The advice I give to any couple looking to book a wedding photographer is meet photographers. Meet three or four, make sure that you get to see full weddings from the photographers. Everyone's got greater sets they can show you over a career. Really, really need to sit down with them and go through, right, what did you give to a bride and groom? Let me see the last wedding that you did and see if that's the kind of level of work that you want to be. I always think of the photographer as being the third element to a wedding. And if the bride, the groom, and the photographer is the closest person to them on the day, you're there from the prep shots in the morning to the first dance, very close to them. And you want to have someone who you want to look forward to being there on the day rather than going, oh God, it's the photographer. The things that make an ideal wedding shoot for me, I think, tends to be the personality of the people that are there. Having a fun couple and fun friends make for fantastic weddings. I've done a number of weddings last year whereby people are just there to really enjoy the day. Some people can occasionally get caught up in, whether it be nerves or whatever it may be, and the day seems a little bit stifled. But when you get a couple who are obviously made for each other, they're deliriously happy and they just want to get out and have a good day and celebrate it with their friends, that makes for fantastic photographs. It really does.